We knew about gangs, AA pages, and video games. We roamed the streets creating adventure. We walked 10 blocks to spend 15 cents on a pack of gun leaders. We looked for a new jungle gym set to play at the projects. We threw fighting tournaments where all fights ended in a nod of peace. We took revenge on stuck-up teenage girls by harassing them while they flirted with older guys. We hunted for crayfish at creeks and ponds. We played baseball using 2x4 wooden planks and wooden broomstick bats. We ran relay races around the block over and over again until our feet had blisters. We played Chinese jump rope until we couldn't see the lines of the rope anymore. We invented ghost stories about the houses around us and dared kids to go confront them. We brought home cats from the Chinese church, hoping to raise them without actually telling our parents. We wrote love letters and hid them on sidewalk crevices for our crushes to find instead of sending emails encoded with words like K-I-T, H-O-T, and some other C-R-A-P. Each day always held something new, and we were never at a loss for ideas. But today, our brothers and sisters, our nieces and nephews, our kids, are perpetually in a state of boredom. Surrounded by the internet, PS2s, digital cable, and more, they still sulk, wallowing in their boredom, waiting for those 5 minutes of stimulation to take away the emptiness. For they have lost something that poverty gave the rest of us, an imagination. Woo!